part 4. This video is a continuation of an actual Movie Maker demonstration set up to show you how I edit videos. In part 4, a video is created to show a graphic of a Happy Mail envelope with addresses on it. The video is created and saved to YouTube. Then I show you how to use YouTube's enhancement video editing tool to blur out the addresses. I just learned about the blurring tool and see where it can be very useful for videos that display envelopes from Happy Mail and for Urban Sketch videos for privacy reasons. It's Art Weaver and I have the free version 5. And I'm going to create a new project, but I'm going to go ahead and draw this and put it in a fast-forward segment just for demonstration purposes. We start out by drawing some graphics for our Happy Mail envelope. I decided to draw an eye. Now, I am drawing with my cursor, so it's a little bit different. I wish I had a tablet to draw with, but I don't. I'm just playing with putting some whites in the eyes and some eyelashes, coloring in the eyeball, putting some eyeshadow, decided some pretty 1980s eyeshadow, put a little skin around it, isolating it, filling in the background, then I'm just giving it a frame. Putting a little shadow around the eye. I'm going to scribble in an eyebrow, putting in some eyelashes, some on the bottom, put a little shadow around the eyeball itself. Okay, now I'm going to write the return address on the envelope. It's Amy Anywho, and there's an address in any town, and it's going to my best forever friend on Friendship Lane in Maryland, any state. Now I'm going to take that envelope and put it on another graphic, and I'm enlarging it so that it looks like an envelope. And then I decide I'm going to use, well, I saved it, and then I use that eye as a Happy Mail decoration, some embellishment on the envelope, put a stamp out there. Then I'm writing Happy Mail on the envelope. Yes, Happy Mail. And then I'm going to write the Mary Atelier YouTube channel. And there's my Happy Mail envelope. I'm going to save it. I'm in my Windows program. I'm going to make this a separate video. And I'm just going to build a shell of a program really fast. You've seen me do this. So I'm going to bring in my template of the last program that I did. I'm going to save my project. Then I'm going to get rid of all my music. Remove my music, which I don't have too much music in this one. Removing my music. I'll leave the beginning music in there. I'm going to move this up here just to save it for temporary. And then I'm going to start removing all my video segments that I don't want. Remove, 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 remove. I'm hitting the delete key. Just getting rid of video segments here from my old project. Now, at this point, I'm going to add a video here, which is my Happy Mail video. My Happy Mail. My Happy Mail finish. Put that right here. Move this here. Let's expand it. We don't want that. I'm going to change my format here to none. All of this text, I'm going to make just one little lowly period. Oh! And I'm going to move him down here. I'm going to change the length to 1250 and the length of my text to 1250. Okay. I'm going to leave my splash screen in there. I'm going to change my part 3. I'm going to change this part. Okay, I changed my font to black. I think I want this. Yeah, I think that's good. Today is April 8th. I'm good with that because I'm going to keep it. Okay, so let's put in some indie music here. Home, add music at current point. Actually, what we could do here is I'm going to create an Audacity file. I'm going to create a recording for you here while I'm doing that. This is like a voiceover. And I'll show you more about voiceovers. I'm just going to go out and do it, and you can watch. I'm using a microphone, internal microphone tool called Audacity. If you have a Windows system, you can also use the sound recorder. Here's your sound recorder up here. I was using it, but I very seldom use it now. So I'm just going to close it out. But almost every Windows system has the sound recorder. I like this Audacity. It's a software. I have a link to it in my description box below. I bring up a screen something like this. And this is how it looks in the full screen. I'm not going to take time now to explain it all. This is just what I do. Let's go back out here and go to this point where I can read it. And then I bring up my tool and I start. And you can see it start recording when I start talking. I click this little red button here. This is a demonstration of how to blur portions of a video you created, which you do not want the viewer to be able to see. The blurring effect will be done in the YouTube enhancement options in your video creator. And then I press that little yellow square to stop it. I enhance it. I have it in stereo mode, which, go back to the front, you can see all my sound waves of my voice reading that. I go in and I delete this first portion. Edit, remove, delete. Sometimes I'll delete a little pause in here. Edit, remove, so that my voice flows better. And I'll show you more about this in a separate video. I'm just doing it to get my voiceover, to get my voiceover ready. Edit, remove, delete, and then I edit. I shorten it up, I get rid of all the unnecessary sounds in there. So you want to hear what I recorded? Watch this little bar right here where my cursor is. It will move. I'm going to hit the green arrow and listen to it. Hopefully it'll sound okay. This is a demonstration of how to blur portions of a video you created, which you do not want the viewer to be able to see. The blurring effect will be done in the YouTube enhancement options in your video creator. Okay, I'm really happy with that. So I'm going to file, I'm going to export it. And I'm already out there. You can see all my other voiceovers up here. I call them odd files for odd for audio file. And I'm going to call this odd one happy mail. I'm going to put right in here. This helps me identify it when I need to put it in my program. So save it. Okay, and it's exporting it. Now I can close this out. I don't want to save my changes because I've already done that. Come back to my Movie Maker. I'm at the portion to where my text is going to flow across the screen, and I'm going to go to my Home tab, Add Music, and then I have to navigate to my file where it was stored, right here. Open. And it is only 34.46, so I can shorten my video to my music tools is oh, my music tools is only 14.91, so I can shorten my video to 14.91, and my text tools to 14.91, and that will line everything up together. Okay, so this is going to be a really short video, 1 minute and 1.41 seconds. Let's go ahead and oh, let's put in our ending. Well, we can copy this Leslie Strutt music file and put it right here and go to Music Tools, and I want it longer than 12 seconds, so I just put in 999 and it will go to the end. File, save, go here, project view, and let's see what we have here. This is why we edit. I have my little text bar right up here. I put that up there to save it temporary. Actually, it's not going to, I'm going to remove it in this video because I've got identifying information all the way through here, so I really don't need it there. So file, save. In other videos, I might have moved, I had it down here, I might have moved it back to the top for another video. So let's go ahead and let's just play it and see what happens. Go to the front and play. A demonstration of how to blur portions of a Oh, video. now see what happened? I deleted my text. So I'm going to, I've saved this. This is a good thing to see. I've saved this video, but while I still have my program open, I can get my text back. Somehow, as I was deleting this text, I also deleted the other text that I had. I wiped it out. Okay, let's see if we can just remove this without removing the other. Nope, I can't. Isn't that interesting? Let's change this back to 5 seconds, 3 seconds. Text tools here. Let's change this to 2 seconds and remove. This is why when you create your videos, this is just how you review it and edit it and make sure that, okay, I'm going to save it again. Make sure that it has everything you want. Play it through. Even if it's a 34-minute video, after you do enough of this, you'll realize that at the very end, watch that whole entire 34-minute video before you put it live on YouTube. You'll be happy if you caught something really serious. Okay, now I'm just going to play it one more time. It's only a minute. This is a demonstration of how to blur portions of a video you know, I think I'm going to put part four in here. I think I'm just going to make it a part of this whole project. I think I'm gonna come in here and type part four. And it will be part four by the time this video goes live. Yeah, I like that. That was just another little edit in there before I saved my movie. So let's just continue playing it. Let's start at the voiceover. This is a demonstration of how to blur portions of a video you created, which you do not want the viewer to be able to see. The blurring effect will be done in the YouTube enhancement options in your video creator. Save it. This is an editing process. I have a Happy Mail envelope here, and what I'm going to do is show you how I'm going to blur out the addresses in YouTube. So if you happen to be showing Happy Mail in your video and you forget and show somebody's address and you don't want to re-record your video, you have the ability to blur out that address. When I go urban sketching, I just found this out. I think a part of it has always been out there, but they made an enhancement to it, and I learned about it actually from the video creators YouTube channel. It's called Video Creators. I'll put a link to that channel in my description box below. So you've heard the rest of it. I'm just going to save it. And then I like to make it small again and change the size of my window. And I'm going to save this movie for computer. And I'm going to make this ML5. Save. And I'll come back when we're ready to upload it to YouTube and show you the rest. Okay, we're at 96, 97, 98% complete, almost ready to finish. Didn't take long at all. Here's our movie. Now, I will say that this is not saved as an HD file. This is a straight MP4 file. This is not an HD file. An HD file has a little bit higher quality. That's all I'm going to say about it. I just know it's higher quality. I usually convert my files into HD files. I have another utility that does that, but I'm not going to go into that right now. I'm just going to upload this MP4 file. So here it is out here. Here's the Happy Mail envelope, and what we're going to do is blur out the street addresses. We're going to leave Amy Anywho and My Best Friend Forever. That's a postage stamp, and this represents Happy Mail artistic decoration. Looks like maybe I should be sending this to Shannon Green because her logo is an eye. I'm in my folder that has the MO5. Movie saved. This is a straight MP4 file. This is not an HD file, just for your information. I'm going to just drag and drop that into my private settings on my YouTube channel. And there it is, and I'm going to title it, usually, well, let's go out there. Here's my title. I copy. I haven't even got to the blur part yet. But I need to fill all this in because I'm going to send it live tomorrow. Everything is good. I got my thumbnail in there. I'm going to say publish on April 9th, which is tomorrow. So I'm going to hit keep private until the given date.